Welcome back to 2230, your source for comprehensive news coverage. Today, we delve into the recent parliamentary session where Senior Minister of State for Transport, Amy Corr, addressed concerns regarding road safety at the junction of Tampines Avenue 1 and Tampines Avenue 4 following a tragic six-vehicle crash. During the session on Tuesday, May 7, PAP MP for Sembawang GRC, Poli San, directed inquiries to Minister Amy Corr regarding measures to enhance safety at the junction where the accident occurred on April 22. This devastating incident claimed the lives of a 17-year-old student and a 57-year-old woman. Minister Corr reassured Parliament that the junction was designed with international safety standards in mind. She emphasized the adequate line of sight for road users, with proper road curbs, lane markings, and arrow indicators installed conspicuously. Additionally, she highlighted the ongoing efforts of the Land Transport Authority, LTA, to enhance road safety, including the implementation of red-amber-green, RAG, arrows at over 1,200 traffic junctions since 2018. Junctions equipped with RAG arrows have shown a significant 40% reduction in traffic accidents, with plans to extend this initiative to more junctions in the future. Moreover, Minister Corr detailed the implementation of 371 school zones and 40 silver zones as of 2023. These zones, strategically placed near schools and areas with senior residents, feature various safety measures such as designated crossing facilities, reduced speed limits, additional crossings, and speed bumps. Silver zones have notably contributed to an 80% reduction in accident rates among senior pedestrians. In light of the accident, concerns over road safety prompted members of Parliament to raise questions regarding penalties for reckless driving and speeding under the Road Traffic Act, RTA. Minister of State for Home Affairs, Muhammad Faisal Ibrahim, provided insights during the session, highlighting penalties for dangerous driving causing death. These penalties include imprisonment ranging from 2 to 8 years for first-time offenders, up to 15 years for repeat offenders, accompanied by a minimum 10-year driving disqualification. Despite overall improvements in road safety, Minister Faisal expressed concern over a 12% increase in fatal accidents in 2023. However, he noted a positive trend over 5 years, with accidents resulting in injuries or fatalities decreasing by approximately 10%. Leading causes of fatal accidents were attributed to failure to maintain proper lookout and control of vehicles. Minister Faisal emphasized enforcement measures and initiatives to promote responsible driving behavior, such as the Safe Driving Course. We urge our viewers to engage with us by leaving comments, liking, sharing, and subscribing to our channel for more updates on crucial matters like road safety.
欢迎回到 2230, 这里是您全面新闻报道的来源。今天我们将深入探讨最近的议会会议，交通部高级国务部长 Amy Corr 就淡宾尼大道一号和淡宾尼大道四号交界处发生的一起严重六车相撞事故所引发的道路安全问题进行了回应。在5月7日星期二的会议上，淡宾尼及选区人民行动党国会议员潘立山向 Amy Corr 部长提出了关于加强事故发生地点安全措施的询问。这起悲剧性事件发生在4月22日，造成了一名17岁学生和一名57岁女性的死亡。部长 Corr 向国会保证，这个交叉路口是按照国际安全标准设计的。他强调了道路用户充分的视线，适当的道路路缘时，车道标线和箭头指示器被醒目的安装。此外，他还强调了陆路交通管理局 LTA 为增强道路安全所做的持续努力，包括自2018年以来在超过1200个交通路口安装了红、琥珀、绿、RAG 箭头。配备 RAG 箭头的交叉路口显示出交通事故减少了 40% 的显著效果，计划将此举扩展到更多的路口。此外，寇尔部长详细介绍了截至2023年实施的371个学校区和40个银色区，这些区域被战略地放置在学校附近和老年人居住区域， 包括各种安全措施，如指定的过街设施、降低的速度限制、额外的过街通道和减速带。银色区域在减少老年行人事故率方面做出了显著贡献，减少了 80%。 在事故发生后，对道路安全的担忧促使国会议员提出了有关根据道路交通法 RTA 对危险驾驶和超速行驶处罚的问题。内政部国务部长穆罕默德·法伊沙尔·伊布拉辛在会议上提供了见解，强调了危险驾驶致死的处罚。这些处罚包括对首次违规者的2至8年监禁，对重犯者的最高15年监禁，以及至少10年的驾驶资格禁止。尽管道路安全总体有所改善，但法伊沙尔部长对2023年致命事故增加了 12% 的情况表示关注，但是他指出了5年来的积极趋势，即导致受伤或死亡的事故数量减少了约 10%。 导致致命事故的主要原因归因于未能保持适当的警觉和对车辆的控制。法伊沙尔部长强调了执法措施和促进负责任驾驶行为的各项举措，例如安全驾驶课程。我们敦促我们的观众通过留言、点赞、分享和订阅我们的频道，以获取更多关于道路安全等重要问题的更新。